Now let us see the implementation of queue using arrays. So here we declared the namespace for cout, cin, etc. And then we have declared the maximum length of the array to be 10. And we are using the template for general data type. So here we are declaring a class called queue and then two pointers, rear and front, through which we can access and remove, and then an array where it has a maximum length as 10. And t is nothing but according to that template, whatever. If you want to store an integer, you can store. If you want to store a string, you can store a string. So for that only we are using the template class. Then we are declaring a constructor where we initialize the pointers, rear and front. Rear is minus 1, and once you add data, this becomes 0. It shows the first index where we insert the data, and so on. Then front is also now 0. So it there is no data in this, so that is also pointing 0. Now these are all the functions, other member functions: is full, is empty, nq, dq, destroy q, print q, peek, and size q. The size q will return what is the number of elements at any point of time in the queue. Now the implementation part of the functions is full. Now it checks for whether it is maximum length. Rear is maximum length minus 1. What do you mean by this? Already we know it is 10. So if it has reached 9, 0 to 9. If the rear is 0 to 9, that means it has reached the 9. If rear is 9, it has reached the maximum length. So you cannot add more. So in that case, it returns a full, return 1. Else it returns a 0. So this will functions will be used while inserting the data into the queue. Now is empty. It checks whether rear equal to minus 1. That is, once all the elements are removed, we keep on modifying the rear pointer. In which case, when all there is no data, the rear becomes minus 1. So if it is minus 1, then you return a 1, stating that a queue is empty. Else return a 0. This will be used while deleting a data from the queue. Now here, this is NQ operations, where we use, we pass the data to be entered into the queue. Now it checks for whether it is full. If it is full, it cannot add data. So we are checking if it is not equal to 1. Now some space is there. So now what you do is rear plus plus. That is, we are adding the, we are moving the pointer, and then in that position, you add the data. So in Q array of rear, you add the data. Else what you do is, you, if it is equal to 1, then what you say is it cannot be added since it is full. Then dq, here you the value to be returned, for that you have declared a temporary variable which is of type t. Then you are checking whether the queue is empty or not. If it is not empty only, you can remove an element. So in del data, this temporary variable, the one which is pointed by the front, you just store it in a temporary variable, and then you are going to now modify this front. So here what you have to do is whether there is a single element in the queue. If it is a single element, then both rear and front will point to that element. So for that condition, you are checking, because in the queue there may already many elements might have been removed. Now there may be only one element, so you have to check that condition also. In that condition, you have to modify the rear to be minus 1 and front to be 0, and make it to be a queue to be empty. So in order to do that, we are just checking whether the front is equal to rear, in which case you modify the front and rear to be 0 or minus 1, rear to be minus. Else, say for example, there are 5 elements already in queue, only the first element you are removing, then just simply make front plus plus, so that the next front is moved to the next element, in which case we lose the element pointed by front. So now the front becomes front plus plus, that it is pointing to the next element. Else, if it is not returning 1, then you do. If it is returning 1, which means it is empty. So you say Q is empty and cannot delete. Now PQ, it is simple, just printing the element which is pointed by the front. So here also you check whether some it is empty or not. If it is returning 1, then means Q is empty. Else only you can see some element. So you are doing the checking. And print Q. It is traversing the element in the Q. So there also, if it is not empty only, you can see what is in the Q. So first you are checking for empty of Q. If it is not true, that is, it is not empty, then you have a for loop where the pointer starts from front to rear. You print the element in there by using the index, by making the index to point from front to rear. Then destroy. I want to destroy the whole queue. In that case, simply change the pointers. If you make rear equal to -1, front equal to 0, now you cannot access, even if the elements are there, you cannot access, because we have the strict rule that in queue you can access only through the front and rear. So simply make that front to be 0 and rear to be -1. Now it's that you have destroyed the queue. Then size of the queue. At any point of time, you may want to see what is the number of elements. So here, you for that you keep a temporary variable count to may initialize it to 0. Then from front to rear, you just traverse and increment the count +++. Now, when after going through, it will print only the, it will count the number of elements in the queue and you return it to the main program.